Welcome to Chris BI. My name is Chris Wagner. Today, we're going to be going over how you can bring in column-level security on measures, the security multiple. All right. Thank you guys so much for joining us today. Hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, turn on alarms, share this with your coworkers if you want to get better security around your tabular models. This is an exciting solution. I like this one because of how quick it can be to implement. And in many cases, this will be more than sufficient for a lot of the models that we're working with. Some pros and cons that come along with this method. Basically, you create a security multiple that you then multiply your base measures by. And where people have access, it's a one. And where they don't, it's a zero. Thus, ensuring that they can see, you know, the appropriate measure for the appropriate time. We want to dive in. We want to take a look at how this works and how you do this, because there's kind of some pros and cons with this one, because this one is security-ish. So, not appropriate. If you're going with external customers or it's something that is really, truly hardcore, needs to be locked down. Many cases, you will find there are multiple layers of security with this. That can be good enough. Don't over-engineer anything that you have. You want to be very cautious, because you need to have that conversation. You need to understand what those bounds are and how you need to manage this environment accordingly. Let's head over to my desktop. I'll show it to you. Okay, so as you can see, I've got one measure that is without the security multiple, and I've got one measure that is with the security multiple. It's really easy to set this up. You basically create it's a security multiple table, right? So it's the RLS multiplier, yes and no, and the multiplier is a 1 and 0. So people have access to information, yes. The 1, no, it's a 0. And then you just basically create a cost multiplier or a multiplier on there for the information. That's the sum of these values. Inside your fact table, you create a measure that's based on that cost multiplier, okay? You know, most people, this will be a times one. And for those people who don't have access to it, it'll be a times zero. So real easy to do. Then you just simply go into your modeling view, and under your roles, you go to your RLS multiplier. And if someone is in the no cost role, they get a no. And everyone else is going to by default get that one, that yes, right? So you set this up. You hit save, and now we can test this by viewing it as that role. So I go to no cost, click on OK, and you can see I now no longer have access to that cost information, right? So on one side, I have access to the cost, and on this one, I do not have access. Super easy for implementation, right? Like the amount of time it takes you to put this in is very small, very little modeling effort. The multipliers, relatively easy to add in. This is excellent for measures and on fact tables. You know, this works really well there. There's some kind of cons that come into this. You know, you are reliant upon users to use the measures that you've built for them, because they could create a report level measure that just removes the cost multiplier. So there's some challenges that can come with that. Now there's some ways you can mitigate that, right? You could create measures that do this, right? And then and instead of exposing the cost multiplier one, you could create a new measure for reporting, right? So total cost report equals, and this is where you put in that with the rollover security measure. Seller total product cost, reseller total product cost, RLS, right? Put this in, and you then hide the other measure, and then you use this one, or you even move that into another table that you've hidden, right? And you just use this one measure for in your report. That will really obscure that multiplier and what that base value is. You could start to leverage security through obscurity there. Would recommend, if you're going to do this, add in some policies, add in some disclaimers that basically call out that, you know, doing this type of activity inside your organization is a terminable offense. have that as part of your annual training. Generally, you can manage that through policies. This type of solution is great for, you know, internal companies. Hey, if I need to have this type of security in place by the end of the sprint, here you go. This is awesome. Low to no data engineering work, a little bit of work on the analysis services side or on the model side, and you're up and running. Awesome. Thank you guys so much for coming out. I hope you found that this like security multiple is a viable solution inside your company, or you understand where it might not be a viable solution, right? So maybe you're using this and you didn't realize, oh crap, I might be exposing something, right? So hopefully you found this to be informative. Again, like, subscribe, leave a comment, send it over to your coworkers. Tell them to take a look at this. Turn on that alarm bell. That would be super great. And I thank you all so much for joining in. I really appreciate it. You have a great day. Peace.